You're listening to Meditating the Word. This year, we will be reading the Bible in a year using the Blue Letter Bible 1 year chronological plan. We'll read the entire Bible in the order the events occurred chronologically using the World English Bible. If you would like a copy of the reading plan we are using, you can download a copy from blueletterbible.com. You'll find a link in the notes. Subscribe to this podcast on your favorite podcast platform so you don't miss any episodes. This is Day 11. Today we'll be reading Job chapters 29 through 31. Let's get started. The Book of Job, chapter 29. Job again took up his parable and said, "Oh, that I were as in the months of old, as in the days when God watched over me, when his lamp shone on my head, and by his light I walked through darkness, as I was in my prime, when the friendship of God was in my tent, when the Almighty was yet with me, and my children were around me, when my steps were washed with butter, and the rock poured out streams of oil for me, when I went out to the city gate, when I prepared my seat in the street. The young men saw me and hid themselves. The aged rose up and stood. The princes refrained from talking and laid their hand on their mouth. The voice of the nobles was hushed, and their tongues stuck to the roof of their mouth. For when the ear heard me, then it blessed me. And when the eye saw me, it commended me, because I delivered the poor who cried, and the fatherless also who had no one to help him. The blessing of him who was ready to perish came on me, and I caused the widow's heart to sing for joy. I put on righteousness, and it clothed me. My justice was as a robe and a diadem. I was eyes to the blind and feet to the lame. I was a father to the needy. I researched the cause of him whom I didn't know. I broke the jaws of the unrighteous and plucked the prey out of his teeth. Then I said, I will die in my own house. I will count my days as the sand. My root is spread out to the waters. The dew lies all night on my branch. My glory is fresh in me. My bow is renewed in my hand. Men listened to me, waited, and kept silence for my counsel. After my words, they didn't speak again. My speech fell on them. They waited for me as for the rain. Their mouths drank as with the spring rain. I smiled on them when they had no confidence. They didn't reject the light of my face. I chose out their way and sat as chief. I lived as a king in the army, as one who comforts the mourners. Chapter 30. But now those who are younger than I have me in derision. But now those who are younger than I have me in derision. Whose fathers I considered unworthy to put with my sheepdogs. Of what use is the strength of their hands to me, men in whom ripe age has perished? They are gaunt from lack and famine. They gnaw the dry ground in the gloom of waste and desolation. They pluck salt herbs by the bushes. The roots of the broom tree are their food. They are driven out from among men. They cry after them as after a thief. So that they live in frightful valleys, and in holes of the earth and of the rocks. They bray among the bushes, they are gathered together under the nettles. They are children of fools, yes, children of wicked men. They were flogged out of the land. Now I have become their song. Yes, I am a byword to them. They abhor me, they stand aloof from me, and don't hesitate to spit in my face. For he who has untied his cord and afflicted me, and they have thrown off restraint before me. On my right hand rise the rabble. They thrust aside my feet. They cast their ways of destruction up against me. They mar my path. They promote my destruction without anyone's help. As through a wide breach they come. They roll themselves in amid the ruin. Terrors have turned on me. They chase my honor as the wind. My welfare is passed away as a cloud. Now my soul is poured out within me. Days of affliction have taken hold of me. In the night season my bones are pierced in me, and the pains that gnaw me take no rest. My garment is disfigured by great force. It binds me about as the collar of my tunic. He has cast me into the mire. I have become like dust and ashes. I cry to you, and you do not answer me. I stand up, and you gaze at me. You have turned to be cruel to me. With the might of your hand, you persecute me. You lift me up to the wind and drive me with it. You dissolve me in the storm. For I know that you will bring me to death, to the house appointed for all living. However, doesn't one stretch out a hand in his fall, or in his calamity, therefore cry for help? Didn't I weep for him who was in trouble? Wasn't my soul grieved for the needy? When I looked for good, then evil came. When I waited for light, darkness came. My heart is troubled. It doesn't rest. Days of affliction have come on me. I go mourning without the sun. I stand up in the assembly and cry for help. I am a brother to jackals and a companion to ostriches. My skin grows black and peels from me. My bones are burned with heat. Therefore my harp is turned to mourning, and my pipe into the voice of those who weep. Chapter 31. I made a covenant with my eyes. How then should I look lustfully at a young woman? For what is the portion from God above, and the heritage from the Almighty on high? Is it not calamity to the unrighteous, and disaster to the workers of iniquity? Doesn't he see my ways and count all my steps? If I have walked with falsehood, and my foot has hurried to deceit, let me be weighed in an even balance, that God may know my integrity. If my step is turned out of the way, if my heart walked after my eyes, if any defilement has stuck to my hands, then let me sow and let another eat. Yes, let the produce of my field be rooted out. If my heart has been enticed to a woman and I have laid wait at my neighbor's door, then let my wife grind for another and let others sleep with her. For that would be a heinous crime. Yes, it would be an iniquity to be punished by the judges, for it is a fire that consumes to destruction and would root out all my increase. If I have despised the cause of my male servant or of my female servant when they contended with me, what then will I do when God rises up? When he visits, what will I answer him? Didn't he who made me in the womb make him? Didn't one fashion us in the womb? If I have withheld the poor from their desire, or have caused the eyes of the widow to fail, or have eaten my morsel alone, and the fatherless has not eaten of it. No, from my youth, he grew up with me as a father. I have guided her from my mother's womb. If I have seen any perish for want of clothing, or that the needy had no covering, if his heart hasn't blessed me, if he hasn't been warmed with my sheep's fleece, if I have lifted up my hand against the fatherless, because I saw my help in the gate, then let my shoulder fall from the shoulder blade, and my arm be broken from the bone, for calamity from God is a terror to me. Because of his majesty, I can do nothing. If I have made gold my hope, and have said to the fine gold, you are my confidence, if I have rejoiced because my wealth was great, and because my hand had gotten much, if I have seen the sun when it shined, or the moon moving in splendor, and my heart has been secretly enticed, and my hand threw a kiss from my mouth. This also would be an iniquity to be punished by the judges, for I would have denied the God who is above. If I have rejoiced at the destruction of him who hated me, or lifted myself up when evil found him, I have certainly not allowed my mouth to sin by asking his life with a curse. If the men of my tent have not said, who can find one who has not been filled with his meat? The foreigner has not camped in the street, but I have opened my doors to the traveler. If, like Adam, I have covered my transgressions by hiding my iniquity in my heart, because I feared the great multitude, and the contempt of families terrified me, so that I kept my silence and didn't go out of the door. Oh, that I had no one to hear me! Behold, here is my signature. Let the Almighty answer me. Let the accuser write my indictment. Surely I would carry it on my shoulder. and I would bind it to me as a crown. I would declare to him the number of my steps. I would go near to him like a prince. If my land cries out against me, and its furrows weep together, if I have eaten its fruits without money, or have caused its owners to lose their life, let briars grow instead of wheat, and stinkweed instead of barley. The words of Job are ended. Father God, thank you for your word. Thank you for the example of Job's life and his faithfulness. Oh, Father, that we could live a life as outstanding as his, and be eyes to the blind, feet to the lame, father to the needy. Although he was wealthy, his confidence wasn't in his gold or his riches, but in you alone, Father. And Father, thank you for the new covenant based on even better promises. How amazing it is to not have to ever wonder if I'm good enough, or to make my case before you by reciting my good deeds, because our righteousness isn't in us or in our deeds, but in Christ alone. You are so good to us. Thank you, Father. Amen. Please join us in our Facebook community, where I share my thoughts about the day's reading, and I invite you to do the same. You'll find a link in the notes. And again, thank you for joining me on this journey of reading the Bible in a year. I can't wait to see you tomorrow as we continue our journey. Until next time, be blessed and be a blessing.